Hi. How's it going? Do you remember me? I'm Challenger. And this is the Challenger radio station here in St. Louis, Missouri. I bet you knew that. I knew it. And thought I'd get on here and say hello. Let me turn this down. Something happened there. So how's it been going? Everything's been pretty much cool around here compared to the summer. It's still summer, but yesterday was a little hot. We turn off the ACs a little more now. Though at night, you know, it gets so nice and cool. I turn off the one in the living room, and we keep the one in the bedroom going though, because we do like it nice and cool in the bedroom. It still gets up here. Just the other day it was 92. And it's still getting in there. It's still getting heat, you know. But it's moving its way toward the fall and the winter, and it's going to be nice. I have the idea that we're not going to have a winter. Because we got 108 degrees. Twice. Might have been three times. But the temperature and the weather's been acting so strange lately that I think we won't have a winter. I think we barely had a winter last year. Had some cool temperatures. I think we had some a dusting of snow here and there sometimes. Nothing really to speak of. No accumulation that would give you any indication that there's winter going on. But who knows, maybe we'll get flooded. I've got some friends of mine that says that it's going to be ridiculous. As far as winter goes, we're going to get all kinds of snow and sleet and thunder snow. Could be. Could be. I mean, seeing stranger things. But I'm of the belief that I don't think we're going to have too much of a winter this year. I believe that in Halloween, we're going to have 80 degrees. 85. 85 degrees. What? I am. Yeah, say it again.
Hello,
YouTube. Good morning on this beautiful 2012, 13th of September. That's right, on the video. I'm sure they'll hear you. You sound good in my speaker. Alright, let me get back to it. I think I got pneumonia, or I got a good attitude, which is a razor.
I'm having an adjustment.
An adjustment?
Yeah, my attitude.
Oh, yeah, well, everybody needs that every once in a while.
Oh, yeah, baby.
I need one more than most people. That's my good friend, lifelong friend. Wow, man, also known as Reese. You know something? I don't know. He's about 16 miles away from me, and he's hit me way up there in the red. He's got a hell of a good station, and he lives in a bowl. You got the interstate. You're traveling along the interstate, you know. And he's on, here's the interstate, and he's down here in the bowl. Interstate be traveling right by his house, but he's down in this depression. It's a bowl all the way around. And right next to him is this huge 300-foot freestanding four-legged tower, red and white. It's gorgeous, and it's been there for as long as I can even remember. I mean, it's beautiful. And it's right in his backyard. It's quite a bit higher than he is, though. And I was saying, we were both discussing, hey, maybe we could put your antenna up on that thing. Yeah, they wouldn't like that. But I was wanting to tell you, I don't know if I've ever told you. So it's the 420 at the 240 standing by on 19. And I'd like to discuss with you something. This is what I'm trying to discuss with you. This. Let's take this off right now because it's hanging. Get out the way. This is the Cobra. Ooh. The Cobra 18 WX STII. I thought it was a two. Two I's. But they're II. I noticed it when I downloaded the PDF. It's two small I's, not two large I's. Two small I's. So it's the Cobra 18 WX STII. Now the WX, of course, stands for weather, because we do have the weather band on there. Seven weather channels available to you on this radio. The ST indicates that this is a sound tracker. Now the sound tracker's got some rave reviews from people, and then it also got a lot of bad reviews from a lot of experienced operators. They stated that they didn't like the sound tracker. Now the sound tracker is supposed to work on both receive and transmit. On transmit, you say. What can it do on transmit? Has it got a built-in linear? Maybe it's got a built-in modulator. What's it got that makes it do something on transmit? Well, what we have is the sound tracker enhances on receive. You're received by knocking down a little bit of the noise and actually amplifying some of your received signal. It does this in various proprietary ways, and I can't get into it because I don't know. Gives you a little bit of a story about it on a PDF file that you can get from Cobra. But it does work. I've used it several times, and it does seem to work. And on transmit, it states that the transmit will be enhanced by utilizing more effectively the RF that is available at this particular radio. Using the RF more effectively, increasing its dynamic range, and possibly increasing its wattage, which it would theoretically, if it went beyond the 4 watts, would be illegal. And they couldn't sell this radio. I've never been into it. Unfortunately, it's a Chinese radio. And you know, Cobra's making Chinese radios. Cobra's now making Cobra 29s. And all these new radios are coming out of China. I don't know how you feel about that. How do you feel about that? All these radios coming out of China. You know, most of them came out of, how they go with, like my Cobra 2000 came out of the Philippines. That's supposed to be a good one. The Philippines and Malaysia are supposed to be very good radios. They do wonderful work there. Where on the other hand, I've heard that the Chinese are piss poor on their radio production lines. I've heard many, many Chinese radios are finding themselves in the trash can. They're so bad, some of them say, that they don't even bother trying to have them repaired or fixed or modified or anything. They just throw them in the trash. I'm finding a lot of these used on the used market. I bought this one for $10. $10 bill. I don't know. But it's got the dual watch DW. Dual watch. That means that, like, say, first you want to use it, your dual watch, you would turn the radio on. Oh. It works! It's alive! It's alive! So you would go ahead and hit, like, not 19, then you would hit the dual watch and let it beep. And then it came, it's supposed to beep. Let's try it again. Oh, it beeped. And then, you're on 19. So you want to go ahead and go up to 24. You'll notice that one of the segments is out on 24, on any of them. The segment right there is out. The segment right in the middle, right there. So we got it on 19, then you would turn it to your second channel that you want to be monitoring. And you hit it again. And then 19. And then hit scan. Turn up your squelch. And there she goes. But she's scanning all 40. Let's try that again. First, we'll go to 20. Boom. Then we'll go to 40. Now I hit scan. Oh, look at it, scanning already. 20-40. What I would normally use it on would be 19. And 24. 19-24, I like that. That's a nice little feature. We talk on 19 mostly, but if it gets a little hectic, we switch to channel 24. We call it the Maw channel. Maw Kettle. She was one of our favorite operators. She died a long time ago, but ever since then, we always call 24 Maw Kettle channel because that's where she was all the time. We loved her. We still do. She's been a silent key for a long time. But that's what's going on. Then you have the silent, the sound tracker. And this is very good. I've had a little experience with it. And you have the scan. And the scan will scan all of them. Look at that. Ooh-wee. So let's hook it up maybe. And there it is. See what we can do. Can you hear me?
Yeah, it's a Dixie Cup. Not too bad, actually.
Got a home?
No.
Finally, I've got a home. Yeah, this is a real, I'm a Cobra weather radio. Feeding back through my base. Yep, there it is.
Yeah, sounds good. Sound right?
Yep. How's it sound now?
It's still the same, but by a little
I kicked in the sound tracker and brought you in even better. Sand blue, because it's not even moving the bird meter at all.
No?
Not at all, but it's showing full output on the radio, but it's not showing anything on the bird.
Well, like I say, it's I think it's even more than the bass, as far as, running like this.
Let me put my Turner Plus 3 on it. Yeah.
Alright, try it out.
Trying to get things done. Okay, how's that?
Beautiful.
That sound good?
No. Sounds like you put your hand over the stock pipe. It's still stockish.
Okay, try that. How's that?
It's even more muffled than the stock pipe.
Wow.
I mean, I can hear you and understand you, but it's even more work.
Yeah, let me fix it. This radio needs work.
Yeah, I'm putting my hand on it and see what I'm doing.
Oh, disgusting.
Can you hear that?
Yeah, I'm coming. Hear me? Alright, let me switch back.
Say again?
I'm gonna switch back.
Switch back. Hold on,
come back! Well, I didn't have much, anticipation for this radio. And back in. And then as I just keyed my bass with no antenna. What a dummy. Okay, back in there?
Yeah.
Get in. Maybe it hasn't.
Maybe it has or hasn't. Or maybe it's just a hollow shell of a radio
track. Well, it's a sound tracker, and I know a lot of people have been throwing them sound trackers in the trash. They don't like them, and this one's Chinese. So, I don't know, man.
I wonder what board's in it.
Probably one from a toaster.
I got a toaster board.
Yeah, from a toaster or a Magnavox or a Krako. It's pegging my bird.
Pegging it. Pegging it.
Apparently this thing puts out more in wattage than my bass does because it's pegging my bird.
Yes, sir. That sounds good, girl.
Oh, my goodness.
Looky there.
All right. Let me get back to you. I'm going to put this one away and say goodbye. Hey, don't get me started.
Hey, girl, start it up.
Start it up. I'm getting some feedback from somewhere around here. Must be my base. I'll turn that off.
Yeah, I'm not hearing it.
Hello, come in.
Hey.
Oh, it's feeding back through the speaker when I unkey.
Really?
It feeds back and then it quits. It's like the reverse of a brownie. Let me get back to you in a second. Well, there it is. It works. Needs some work, evidently. But I expected that because it's Chinese. Okay. And that's what we have here. The Cobra soundtrack and radio type thing. The back is nothing to look at. SO239. External speaker. And the power cord has two fuses in line because we have two hot wires. It's got two independent boards in this radio. One is for your CB. The other one, orange, is for your weather radio. So evidently you've got two radios right here. Two separate boards, two separate radios. And then your ubiquitous ground wire. But it's very rare when you see dual like that on a CB radio.